one frustration that is common to all the students doing a dissertation is that once you've collected the data, you tend to feel a bit overwhelmed because you don't know exactly how to withdraw meaning from that data. In this video, I am going to explain a two-step analysis of results that you can follow. And those two steps are individual analysis and global analysis. And I'm going to use a flower patch to explain the process. And you're probably saying, what? Yes, I'm going to use a flower patch to explain the process. And it's interesting enough and generic enough so that anyone, whether you're doing qualitative or quantitative, can understand the process. And what I would like to ask you is to try to understand how the principles that I'm going to explain using the flower patch can be applied to when you're analyzing the results of your interviews, of your focus groups, or of your questionnaires. I'm Dr. Miguel Moital. I am the founder and chief content developer of the Dissertation Academy. And here in the Academy, we are all about bringing you unique tips and tools to help you write a better dissertation. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button and also the bell button so that you're notified every time we publish a new video. Before I explain the two steps, let's divide the patch in four parts. And imagine that these are four major parts in your dissertation. So these four parts could be four tables containing statistical analysis. It could be four main areas or themes you covered in your interviews or focus groups. It could be four pieces of marketing material you are analyzing, or four pieces of anything that reflects, you know, the analysis that you collected. It's important to divide the flower patch or your results into smaller parts because the process starts with reporting individual results. Let's start with the top left-hand corner of our flower patch. We can see that the most prevalent tulip color is red, that the background flowers are white and blue. We can also conclude that one red tulip stem is bent significantly, and that the pink tulip bud is not very open yet, while the red tulip buds are quite open. Moving to the next quarter, we can see that the majority of tulips are of a dark purple color, that the background flowers are of a mixed color, blue, white, and pink. We can also conclude that one red tulip stem is moderately bent, and finally, that the pink tulip buds are not very open yet. If we look at the bottom right quarter, we can observe that not many tulip buds are present. In fact, only 2.5, while the majority of the background flowers are pink with some blue and very few white flowers. No pink or purple tulips are visible. Finally, we can also observe that the red tulip stem is more open than the dark purple one. If we move to the final quarter, we can conclude that there are a variety of tulips from different colors, with background flowers mostly made of blue flowers. And again, one red tulip has a fairly bent stem. Both the light purple and the red tulip in the foreground have quite open buds, while the pink tulip buds are not very open yet. Once we analyzed, once we drew conclusions, made observations about each of the individual parts of our results, we can summarize them. And in front of you, you have a table that summarizes each individual result, the results for each of the quarters in our picture. This is essential because we cannot complete step two without completing step one. And step two is performing a global analysis, drawing conclusions based on the entirety of the individual results. In this instance, we have four quarters of a flower patch, and we made observations about each of those quarters. So we can now actually bring together similar themes. So we commented on tulip colors, on how bent the stems are, how open or closed the buds are. Also, we commented on the quantity of tulips, and also on the color of background flowers. So these are themes that we can now start drawing conclusions about because we have the entire picture of our flower patch. When you do global analysis, you should perform two tasks. The first one is to compare across quarters. So, in other words, compare across more than one result. With regards to the quantity of tulips, we could say that the number of tulips varies across picture quarter, with quarter two containing the highest number, with 9 tulips, and quarter three, the least, with kind of 2.5 tulips showing. With regards to the color of background flowers, we could observe that there is good presence of blue color flowers across all picture quarters. We could also say that white flowers appear scattered and the least present. And we could also observe that pink background flowers are located towards the bottom, while blue occupy the middle and the upper portions of the flower patch. When we look at all the individual results together, we can also provide observations that go beyond individual quarters. In other words, we can also see things that are only visible when the entire picture is put together, when we bring together all the individual results. For example, in relation to tulip colors, we could say that the majority of tulips are dark purple, 8 bulbs, followed by pink with 7, red with 6, with light purple being the least frequent color, with 5 bulbs only. If we wanted to comment on how bent the stems are, we could say that red stems tend to be bent, usually moderately to substantially, whereas other stems do not tend to be substantially bent. We can also comment on how closed or open the buds are, and here we could conclude that pink buds are the less open, while the red ones are the most open. With regards to the size of the bulbs, we could conclude that red bulbs are larger than other buds, and actually we could start speculating as to why the red tulip stems are bent. We could try to start connecting the size of the bulb to the bent stems. Remember that we also observed that the red stems were more bent than the other ones. So, and here we can start to see a link, so we could speculate as to why the red tulip stems are bent. It's because the buds are larger than in the other tulips. And if you want to learn about more great tips and tools to help you write a better dissertation, please consider subscribing to the Virtual Tutor online resource, which is a video book-based resource that contains a lot of innovative tips and tools to help you write a better dissertation. So in summary, whenever you're carrying out your data analysis, you should do it using two stages. Stage one involves analyzing the individual parts, and that's where you're going to make observations about each piece of the puzzle, each quarter of the flower patch, each table in your quantitative analysis, each major theme in your qualitative analysis. Once you've done that, then you can step back and perform stage two, which is carry out the global analysis. And you can do this by comparing across individual parts, but also by stepping back and observing the entire picture. When you bring everything together, what conclusions can you draw? This is a really important element because students do not always carry out this step too. But sometimes it's what differentiates a good dissertation from an outstanding dissertation. So I strongly encourage you to carry out global analysis step two and spend some time perfecting it, because it will help you to gain more marks. That's all for now. Thank you for watching. If you want to learn more about great tips and tools to help you write a great dissertation, there are some videos here, and check the description below for additional videos. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you at the next video.